Hey everyone, welcome to Front of the Apps. I'm Menti, and this is the third exhibition match of the Battleship Brawl Season 7 tournament. In this episode, we've got the Prinz by Smirnov going up against the Admiral Broadsides by Nutterchap. Let's go ahead and get the camera in position here. Get the prediction started. Prinz or Broadsides? You got 1 minute to place your bets. Let's go ahead and get this battle underway. Looks like Broadsides took a direct hit to one of its turrets, and that turret has been destroyed. Right in through here, right into the gun, and wow, did it go through two guns? It went through a gun and then detonated inside another gun. Semi-armor piercing any good? I mean, yeah, it can be. If you basically need to have a hybrid rail to use semi-armor piercing, but it can penetrate decently deep and then, you know, blow up. Itself at quite the disadvantage by always sailing straight toward the enemy. But now it's bringing those rear guns to bear. List really badly, but it has caught up in the damage race since it brought those rear guns to bear. But she is not looking good. Well, there are cram parts in that confetti cluster. Yeah, this is a classic brawl, yeah. Ooh. goes the turret cap. Both clean off. Both ships listing heavily. Uh-oh. For a second there, it looked like Prince was more capsized, but it is listing really badly. Like, it's basically capsizing. Recoil roll control. Uh-oh, Prince can't aim his guns anymore because it's rolled too much. At least not its forward guns. Broadsides might go down here. It's awfully close. While the Prince is rolled over, it's staying afloat. Oh wait, maybe not. No, 80% sinking. I spoke too soon. Prince has gone down. Broadside stays up. Just was able to outfloat it. Alright, so 0 to 70.5 in the first round. Some interesting firing solutions for the gunners. Yeah, no kidding. Bow the Prince getting shredded. Exactly why crossing the T was a thing in real life. But then, if you go to play World of Warships and you do this exact maneuver, the Prince would be the one winning. Broadsides would be getting citadel left and right. Speed indeed. Boink. Thank you. chest. Let's check on the broadsides. I haven't done that in a while. It's not feeling so hot. Now it's the one crossing the D line. Getting its armor and it shot itself. Good job. Way more guns still functional than I thought it did when we first came over. Yeah, the turns are good. Yes, indeed. Broadside's not looking so good. She's going, getting low in the water. Her bow is submerged. A good half of her deck is submerged. Well, left of the deck. They did in the first round, though. Staying nice and stable. Dog's trying to play with the cat. Broadsides is awfully far away. Like, they're awfully far apart right now. How are they not getting DQ? It just doesn't look like it. Oh, there we go. Broadside is getting good too. But how is Prince not? Maybe it's sinking? No? Oh, now it is. But it's a little late. Broadsides is gonna DQ first. So 70.9-0. So going into the third round, this it was moving. Not very much, but it was moving. The propellers were definitely on. I checked that. I don't know. But yeah, going into the third round, the score is 23.6 to 23.5. So, whoever wins this match, whoever wins this round, wins the match. Fuzzy ones are playing together. I know it probably sounds mean, but Allie just sounds like she wants to kill you when she's playing. A weird dog like that. See, now they're both just at my legs and feet. Just coexisting again. Allie was doing the whole the puppy play crouch and lunging at Panther, and he was bap 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 bap. Huh. Are you playing with the pupper, huh? That's the first time I've really seen them, like, heavily play like that. Usually what happens is they'll start to do that, and Panther will go bap bap and then run away. But he was actually, like, squaring up with her this time. It was cute. A lot less crossing of the T this round. Broadside's lost one machine gun. Yeah, they're actually broadsiding each other this time around, indeed. that size is a big boy indeed. It's a chonker. Prince might be in a little bit of trouble, not dead in the water. Just listing and leaning again. Probably not BRM, but Joe Wyden also wouldn't be allowed in this tournament because it would be too wide. That's a turret just completely destroyed. I think the Prinz is going down. Use stone? I don't see any stone. I see wood, metal, and alloy, and some heavy armor. Oh, some stone on the bottom. Ah. Had the budget cut on the bottom armor, huh? Has 12 DQ points somehow. Must have started sinking and then stopped. Excuse me. Boing. Prince is uncapsizing. Ooh, there goes another turret, though. Surprised this one didn't go after those hits. Oh, there it goes. Is the Prinz gonna make it to the end? Looks like it, honestly. And the last turret falls off. Yeah, the only question remaining is whether the Prinz will make it to the bell, which it probably will. But even if it does, it's still going to lose the match. And there's no vote to save you in exhibitions. Time's up. 50-83. I mean, the broadsides wins 51.2-40.3. Wow. Only one person bet on the Prinz, it looks like. And nobody bet on the broadsides. Just, like, no bets whatsoever on this match. So it just... those materials go off into the ether, I guess. Yeah, it was a good fight. It was enjoyable to watch. But that'll be the end of the